Welcome back to the Cosmic Classroom. Let's now talk about the life of stars that live in pairs, double stars, all right? Or binary system. So what happens to a white dwarf? It dies and then what? You know, it becomes it's a white dwarf and then what happens to it? Do they just sit there? Well, if the white dwarf is isolated, yes, it will just sit there, it will cool down, and it will eventually become a black dwarf that we cannot see anymore. Now, if the white dwarf have a companion, then life is much more interesting and more things happen. So let's look, for example, at Sirius and its white dwarf companion. So it's a little thing, it's this white dwarf near this big star, Sirius. But this white dwarf is really important in the life of the system, right? The companionship is really important. So if you have a system on which one of the stars is already a white dwarf, and there is another star, so there are two stars, let's say this is the white dwarf, and this is another regular main sequence star, and they are orbiting each other, and they are happy with their life together, but eventually, this star here that is the main sequence will also die. And as it dies, as all stars die, they expand, they become one big thing. When this star starts to expand, its surface gets close enough to the white dwarf that the white dwarf starts to steal material from the surface of this star. And that's what this drawing is showing you. That the white dwarf companion is stealing material and forming an external layer of hydrogen around it. Well, the white dwarf is really hot, right? It's the core of a star. So as the hydrogen heats there and it accumulates a little bit there, the star comes back to life. It starts fusing hydrogen into helium again. So the star that was dead suddenly comes back to life. There's fusion happening again, the star will shine brightly again. And it will do that a few times as more and more fuel is falling into the surface of the star. You need to let the fuel accumulate a little bit to be at the right density and temperature. But every now and again, now and then, the star will burst, will be luminous. So a nova can happen once, or twice, or three times, as material falls into this white dwarf. It may be that the white dwarf steals so much material from this companion star that the degeneracy pressure of this white dwarf cannot hold it anymore, cannot stop gravity anymore. The star collapses at once when the degeneracy pressure can't hold it. As it collapses, it explodes as a supernova and blows everything away. What's left from this kind of supernova is nothing, not a neutron star, not a black hole. There's just nothing there. But let me qualify the nothing. I'm not saying that material disappeared. I'm just saying that it has been, becomes dust, right? It's spread all around. When the star explodes, it also affects the neighboring star, the one that was its partner. It also blows that star away. It doesn't make that star explode, but it blows that star away. A lot of the material from the outer parts of that star will be blown away, right? Because of so much energy in that explosion. So we call supernova, this final explosion we call supernova, when this core collapses and the whole thing explodes and nothing is left, is called a supernova. Now, I need to tell you that this kind of supernova that leaves no remains and that comes from a binary system with a white dwarf, it's called a supernova type 1. I don't understand why it's called a supernova type 1, right? If there are two stars. And the supernova that explodes when there is one big massive star exploding, it's one big massive star exploding, that's called a supernova type 2. So if you try to use that to memorize, do the reverse, right? If there are two stars, it's supernova 1. If there is one star, it's supernova type 2. I won't go on the why has to do with the lines, the way they were classified before we knew what they were, but that's what it is. So I had a lot of questions about why just binary systems? Is it possible to have three or multiple stellar systems? And yes, we can have multiple stellar systems. In fact, there are a lot of multiple stellar systems. In fact, there are more systems with more than one star than systems with just one star out there, all right? So a star like the sun is less common than stars that live with partners, with other stars. So there are lots of those out there. I have two examples here. One that you must be very familiar with is Polaris, the North Star. It's not really one star, it's three, as you can see. With your naked eye, it's impossible to see because their companions are very bright, very dim, and very close to the main star. But it's actually a system of three stars. Polaris A, Polaris AB, and Polaris B. Right? And here is just a drawing showing one possible configuration out of infinite possible configurations. There are three stars here. This little star is orbiting this one, almost like a moon orbiting a planet, except that they are two stars, and those two stars are orbiting each other. And you may have many stars together, right? When a supernova happens, all the stars that are around, whether it's one, two, or three, they will just be sent away. Most of them will be close enough to a supernova that they won't be able to survive. They'll just be sent away. And I hope that answered your questions, and I hope it helped. I see you next time.